Good morning, Beulah. Welcome to Beulah, the Help Station, where we always believe in helping the youth get where God wants the youth to be. In this year of faith, we thank God for our man of God, who is leading by faith, our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Jarity Black. As we honor our First Lady, Sister Kate Black, this month around the world, we pause to celebrate Women's History Month. Where would we be without women? Throughout history, women have made notable contributions in the areas of science, technology, government, education, sports, entertainment, and religion. Women have broken barriers, shattered glass ceilings, and defied odds, often facing discrimination in the workplace, in society, and even in the church. However, this month and every month, we know that without women such as Harriet Tubman, Barbara Jordan, Zora Neale Hurston, Katherine Johnson, Althea Gibson, Aretha Franklin, Oprah, Michelle Obama, and Vice President Kamala Harris, there will be many roads left untraveled. Even here in our church, we honor the mothers, the sisters, the daughters, the female preachers of the gospel, and every woman and young woman of God who knows she was created for a purpose. Happy Women's History Month. Let's continue to be amazing. Today at Beulah, we begin our Holy Week celebration. Welcome to Palm Sunday at Beulah. Please join us following today's worship service on the lower level for a special meal prepared by our culinary ministry. The best food with the best price in the ATL for Palm Sunday dinner is right here at the Beulah Cafe. Join us this Good Friday, March 29th at 7 p.m. in the sanctuary of the Beulah Missionary Baptist Church for a spiritually uplifting Easter production, From Mary's House, The Story of Jesus is Told. This unique performance, penned by the talented Sister Cheryl Horn Robertson and directed by the visionary Sister Sharon Murray, promises to be a memorable journey through the life and miracles of Jesus Christ. Do not miss this Good Friday opportunity to experience a story that has touched hearts for centuries, brought to life by our devoted church community. Our annual Sunday School Easter program will be held March 30th at 2 p.m. in the Keith Warford Youth Lounge. You can register online and select recitations until March 24th. In-person registration will be available immediately following today's morning worship service on the lower level. Rehearsal for the program participants is Wednesday, March 27th from 5 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. in the Youth Lounge. Our Easter worship service is Sunday, March 31st at 9:30 a.m. The next food giveaway at Beulah is Saturday, March 30th, beginning at 9 a.m. The food boxes are on a first-come, first-served basis, one box per vehicle. There is no need to register. Volunteers are asked to arrive by 6 a.m.
Welcome to Beulah Missionary Baptist Church's Meatless Monday Challenge. Are you ready to make a healthy change for yourself and the planet? Starting on April 1st and ending on June 30th, the Health Resource Ministry is challenging our members to go meatless for 12 days during this three-month period. That's just 4 Mondays each month. And if you're really making strides, there's an extra Monday for you to really finish up strong. And if Mondays don't work for you, no worries. You can pick another day during the week. We encourage you to get creative and share your favorite meatless recipes with each other. Let's inspire each other to eat healthier and protect our planet. I know you can't wait to sign up, so immediately following service, please come down to the lower level and sign in at one of the kiosks. Someone will be there to assist you if you need it, or simply pop down to one of the tables at the bottom of the stairs on the lower level. Registration is also available online at the Beulah website. Remember, it's always important to check with your doctor before making any changes to your diet, as individual needs may vary. Join us in this exciting challenge starting April 1st. In this year of faith, let's make a positive impact together.
Calling all Beulah parents, kids, friends, and community members. We are preparing for a fun-filled, spirit-filled, and learning enhancement summer camp, and we want you to join us. Our camp promises to be a perfect balance of focus and fun. Our mornings will be filled with academics enrichment, including math, science, and reading classes, as well as Bible study, while our afternoons will include swim classes, pickleball, and 1 week of basketball W360 training, field trips, hot breakfast, and lunch, so much more. Summer camp begins May 28th and ends August the 2nd, and we accept the Child Care Assistance Program. For more information and for more details to register, please visit Beulah's website or contact the Family Life Center. Beulah's summer camp is the place to be this summer, and we hope to have your kids here to make this the best summer ever.
We are Beulah. We are Beulah and beyond. Please visit www.beulahbaptist.org for additional information about all the events and activities at Beulah. Thank you for worshiping with us here in the sanctuary or online via our Facebook, our website, or our YouTube channel. Parents, please be reminded that our church nursery is open during our worship service on the lower level for children 1 to 3 years old. Beulah, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Let's have church.
But the Lord has given us
power.
God has not given us the spirit of fear.
But the Lord
has given us
power.
God has not given us the spirit of fear.
But the Lord
has given us
power.
God has not given us the spirit of fear.
But the Lord.
But the Lord.
Good morning, Beulah. Aren't you just feeling good to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Today, I will be reading from the book of Mark, chapter 1, verses 1 through 8. May you please stand for the reading of the word. The beginning of the gospel about Jesus Christ, the Son of God. It is written in Isaiah the prophet, I will send my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way. A voice of one calling in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. And so John came, baptizing in the desert region and preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem went out to him, confessing their sins. They were baptized by him in the Jordan River. John wore clothing made of camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. And this was his message. After me will come one more powerful than I, the thongs of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. I have just read the book of Mark, chapter 1, verses 1 through 8. All right, you may be seated.
Good morning, Beulah. Would you please bow your head for a word of prayer? Father God, we come to you this morning to say thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything you've done for us, Lord. Thank you for everything you're getting ready to do, Lord. Lord, you blessed us so many times that we can no longer keep count, Lord. Father God, we are no deserving of your blessings, Father God. Father God, we ask that you continue to keep your hands on us and walk with us, Lord. Get in us, Lord. Live in us, Lord. Father God, we ask that you continue to keep your hands and watch over the sick and shut in, Lord. Father, be within them, Lord. Get in them, Lord. Live in them, Lord. Father God, heal them where they need to be healed, Lord. Father God, because you know and we don't, Lord. Father God, we thank you for our pastor. Father God, we ask that you continue to keep our steps in alignment with your will, Lord. These blessings we ask in your precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. Oh, we can do better than that. Praise the Lord, church. Oh, come on. We can do better than that. Praise the Lord, church. All right. We just... And before we begin, let's give our young people a hand. Let's support them. If anybody ought to encourage our young people, it should be the church. I mean, so let's Kingsley come up. So I'm thankful for an opportunity. I won't be before you long. Ain't that something the Baptist preachers always used to say? But I promise. Pastor Black, will you please join me down here, please, sir? Let me first say, on behalf of your beloved Beulah Baptist, welcome back. Welcome back. And we all know, grief doesn't stop, after the funeral. And so, church, let's continue to pray for him. Let's continue to lift him up, because not only is he going through grief, but he has to pastor us as well. So, yeah, let's continue to lift him up. And the second thing I wanted to do, Pastor Black, is we want to say thank you. Over 30 years ago, we was in the midst of a pastoral change. And Pastor Black, you came, you accepted the call to come here to shepherd this flock of Beulah Baptist Church. And for 32 years, sir, you've been toiling, you've been tilling, you've been working hard in this vineyard known as Beulah Baptist Church. And we want to take time just to tell you we appreciate you. We love you and we thank you for that. And on behalf of all the members here at the Beulah Missionary Baptist Church, the one on 2340 Clifton Springs Road, we want to present to you this love offering on behalf of the church to say thank you and we appreciate you. God bless you. It is such a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful thing to be able to be back in the house of the Lord with you on this morning. This is Palm Sunday. And we greet each of you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior. Brothers and sisters, I have been removed from you from this pulpit for 3 Sundays. And the Lord has blessed me to make it back. Amen. It has been rough. And it still is. But oh, yesterday and this morning I had a talk with the Lord. And he told me to just come into the house of the Lord with a spirit of praise. Don't come in with a sad face. But come in with a spirit of joy and thanksgiving. I read over, and the Lord told me to review his words in Psalms 100 and verse 4, where he says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. And I rejoice this morning in being able to be back in the house of the Lord, back in the temple here at Beulah with you. My brothers and sisters, I want to just pause here and thank so many of you who have been keeping me and my family lifted to God in your prayers. Thank you so much. We have felt the power of your prayers, and we appreciate you so very, very much. I want to mention here that not only is this a great day because it is Palm Sunday, but this is a great month because we are celebrating and recognizing some special people. We are celebrating and recognizing women. I wouldn't want to live in a world without in a womanless world. God knew that Adam needed a helpmate, and he blessed him with a woman. Amen. And so I want to take this time and opportunity quickly
to just ask that all women in the sanctuary this morning, whether you be on the floor level or in the balcony or joining us here in the pulpit or in the pews, will you please stand wherever you are, every woman. We honor you. We honor you. We praise God for you. We thank God for you. And we certainly pray that God will continue to shower down his blessings upon you. Amen. This month of March, amen, will soon close out, but we will not end our celebration of you women. God bless you and God keep you is our prayer. I want to take this time to just say welcome to all of the members of our Beulah family and our wonderful visiting friends who are joining us this morning. I would like to say welcome to all of those who have tuned in from all across the nation, viewing this service as it is going out virtually. And we certainly appreciate each and every one of you, and we say welcome to you. I would like that all of those who are joining us as visitors in the sanctuary this morning, who are not members of Beulah, would you please stand? God bless you. Amen. We thank and praise God for you. Amen. And we certainly want you to know that we are delighted, we are ecstatic to have you joining us in this time of worship on this Palm Sunday. Thank you so very, very much. Brothers and sisters, Fourth Sundays here at Beulah is Youth Sunday. It is a more casual Sunday. Amen. And we just praise God for our young people. Amen. And on this fourth Sunday, in this third month of this new year, amen, will you just help me give God praise for all of the youth and the young people? Amen, amen. That's somebody's children, somebody's grandchildren, somebody's nieces, somebody's nephews. Amen. We thank and praise God for all of our young people. Amen. And God wants us to make sure that seeds are planted in the hearts, minds, and spirits of all of our young people. Amen. So that as they continue to grow up, they will not forget about that man named Jesus. Amen. Amen. Certainly, again, we want to say welcome to our online worshipers. Amen. And those who are joining us via Facebook and YouTube, amen. As certainly on the website, thank you and welcome to each of you. And today on this Palm Sunday, we recognize and celebrate the Master's tremendous entrance into the city of Jerusalem, where the people tore down palm branches and spread them in the way as they shouted out, "Hosanna! Blessed be the King who cometh in the name of the Lord." Some of them took off their outer garments and spread them in the way as the Master rode into Jerusalem. Amen. And we just praise God as we remember and commemorate his entrance into the city of Jerusalem on this Palm Sunday. Amen. Knowing that Palm Sunday would just be prior to his crucifixion. Amen. Where he would pay the price for our sins. And aren't you glad about it? Amen. As we recognize our youth on this wonderful fourth Sunday, amen, I have been made aware of the fact that there are some special presentations to be made, amen. I want that the individuals who will come, I believe that is Reverend Johnson. Beulah has a special, special relationship with a number of the schools, elementary schools, Barack Obama, amen, and a number of the other middle schools and high schools. And we are touching lives of young people even, amen, in the schools. Amen. Reverend Johnson, our youth minister, would you come at this time? Amen. We have three special plaques, three special awards that we want to present, amen, to some special people at the Cedar Grove, amen, high school. We want to make mention here, amen. And I don't know whether all of these individuals are present, amen, but they will receive these special plaques, amen. The first is in appreciation to Shawanda Patillo, athletic director, amen, of the Cedar Grove football team. Amen. Amen. And if there are members of the Cedar Grove football team here, would you also, amen, join us? Let's give God praise for them as they come. Oh, what a blessing, what a blessing. Cedar Grove, Cedar Grove, Cedar Grove. So proud of you, and we're so thankful to God that he has strategically placed each of you at Cedar Grove to make the crucial and needed difference in the lives of our young people, amen. And certainly, amen, in the area of athletics and sports, amen, we so greatly value and appreciate each of you. Shawanda Patillo, Shawanda, amen, athletic director, amen. Thank you so much, amen. Cedar Grove football team, amen. Class AAA, state champions, amen, amen, amen. Shawanda, God bless you. Amen. Keep up the good work. Amen. This plaque goes out in appreciation to Clifton Spears, principal of Cedar Grove. Amen. Amen. Special thanks, amen, for your hard work, dedication, and leadership at Cedar Grove. Amen. And we appreciate you. Amen. This plaque is presented to you by the Beulah Baptist Church family and the Reverend Dr. Jerry D. Black. Amen. Hoping that you will keep up the good work. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Brother Spears. Amen. God bless you. All right. And our friend Commissioner Johnson, amen, wanted to make sure, amen. Is there a third plaque?
Yeah, there is, but they're not here.
Okay. And this third plaque is to John Adams, head football coach, who could not be here today. Amen. Regrettably, and he sends his regrets. Amen. But still, this plaque is going to get to him. Amen. I'm going to entrust it, amen, to you, coach. Amen. And I know that you'll get it to him. Amen. But we appreciate him for his good work. Commissioner Larry Johnson, God bless you. Amen. 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 He wanted, amen, to make sure that this special presentation would go forth. Amen. And so he worked to have these plaques, amen, made so that they could be donated to each of these wonderful people. Amen. Now, not everyone standing here received a plaque, but let me tell you, amen, you're certainly worthy. And we appreciate each of you. God bless you. Amen. Father God, continue to bless now these wonderful, wonderful individuals who are providing their services, their leadership, dear Father, their expertise at Cedar Grove. Keep each of them in your care. Keep that school safe from all forms of hate, harm, and danger. For we ask it all in Jesus' name, and we say thank you, Heavenly Father, and amen, amen, amen. God bless you. Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you. Brothers and sisters, let me make mention of this fact very quickly, and that is that Good Friday in the sanctuary at 7 p.m. will be our Easter production, amen, which will be this coming Friday at the 7 p.m. hour. And we certainly want that all of us will be in attendance to give our support for this wonderful production that so much hard work has gone into to prepare it. We want to mention from Mary's House, The Story of Jesus is Told, written by Beulah's own sister Cheryl Horn Robinson and directed by our mad director, amen, of Music, Arts, and Drama Department, amen. Director, Sister Sharon Murray. Amen. That's at 7 o'clock this coming Friday evening here in the sanctuary. Please join us and be present. Amen. It will be a treat and a blessing for all of us who will be in attendance. Let me make mention very quickly that our Sunday school department will be having their annual Easter program. Amen. And we are looking forward to a wonderful time. That will be Saturday prior to Easter at 2 p.m. in the Family Life Center, the youth lounge of our Family Life Center next door. And we certainly want that we will come out and support our young people and our Sunday school department in this annual Easter program. It will also be another treat that we don't need to miss out on. On Easter Sunday, we will be celebrating the powerful resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The fact, amen, that he changed the whole atmosphere of the graveyard. When he got up from the dead, got up from the grave, and declared that all power in both heaven and earth was in his hands. And we'll be celebrating the resurrection of our Savior on next Sunday. And we certainly want you to be here for our Easter worship service. Also this week, amen, on this coming Wednesday, will be baptism. And we will be taking souls to the water, men and women, boys and girls, to the water to baptize them on this coming Wednesday evening at the 7 o'clock hour. We're asking that our candidates for baptism would do your very best to make it here no later than 6:30 p.m. so that you can be properly dressed in the baptismal dressing rooms and made ready for the baptismal service that will start at the 7 o'clock hour. We're looking forward to going back there to the pool, amen, to take souls to the water. Is there anybody here who can remember when you were baptized? Always keep that in your memory. Amen. It was a milestone in each of our lives. Amen. The Health Resource Ministry is sponsoring something that is a challenge to many of us. And that is a meatless Monday. A Monday without meat. Amen. Amen. And if you are carnivorous, a meat lover like I am, amen, it will be a challenge. But, amen, a one-day challenge. Amen. And so they're requesting this Meatless Monday challenge, amen. But they're asking it for 3 months, amen. April 1st through June 30th, amen. One day each month, amen. And I'm going to sign up, but I need your prayers. Amen, amen, amen. Because the temptation will be great to find me some neck bones. So keep us lifted in your prayers. Amen. Amen. We want to make mention of this fact, and that is that resource ministry, amen, our health resource ministry, is available on the lower level and outside the main entrance today to register members and friends for the Meatless Monday Challenge. Amen. And so they will be awaiting us, amen, to sign us up so that we can register for these 3 days. Amen. April 1st, amen. And then on through, amen, June the 3rd. Amen. Not every day. Amen. One day each month. Amen. Lord, help us to hold out. Amen. But there are some of us who are going to try, and I hope you can be numbered among them. Amen. I want to quickly thank the chairman of our deacon board. Amen. Amen. Deacon Gerard Owens, amen. The officers and members of Beulah, amen, for this wonderful, wonderful gift. Thank you so much. Amen. On this Youth Day, Sister Black and I are blessed with two of our granddaughters. Amen. Amen. Tangie's two daughters. Amen. And I would like for you to stand. Thank you for being here. Amen. And Paul, amen, is just excited to look out there and see you. It is always good news when those who have been removed from us are blessed to be back with us. And I want to make mention of the fact that it has come to my attention that Reverend David Kuntz, amen, a longtime member of Beulah, has been away from us due to sickness and major surgery. But he's back in the house today. Reverend Kuntz. Amen. There he stands. Amen. God bless you. Thank you so much. Amen. We're so happy to see you and to have you back with us. Here at Beulah, there's always a tremendous spirit of kindness and care and concern. Deacon Linda S. Reed from the Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church of Chicago. Amen. My pastor is Reverend Reginald Wayne Sharp and First Lady, amen, Brianna Sullivan Sharp. I'm known as a snowbird as I drive to Fayetteville, Georgia, to reside with my daughter, Monica, from the Chicago winters. Last year, Pastor Black was concerned and kind enough to come see the lady, namely me, who fell outside our church. That left knee gave away. My hero and a kind lady came running to my rescue. Deacons Andre and Michael are a few names I remember. Thank you to all who helped me that day. So appreciative. I depart Georgia on April 2nd or April 21st. Had to keep my promise to Pastor Black and visit again, although I would anyhow depart Georgia on April 21st. Amen. And we're so happy to have her back with us today. Amen. And wherever she might be, would you please stand if you're able to do so? There she is. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you and keep you. Amen. I would that our choir would get ready to prepare a selection briefly as we prepare, amen, for the dedication precious little ones. Lest I forget, I want to make mention of our sick and shut-in who are in urgent need of our prayers, along with our bereaved and grief-stricken. Reverend James Martin, who is a patient at Emory University Hospital, the Clifton Road location. Amen. He has allowed no visitors or visitation at this time. Amen. But we know God can go where we can. Let's keep him in prayer. Sister Patricia Butler, who is at the Compass Rehabilitation Center, located in Stockbridge, Georgia. Sister Rosemary Johnson, who will undergo a series of tests and possibly will undergo surgery very shortly. Also, Brother Dennis Savage, who is home, recovering from surgery and in need, tremendous need of our prayers for his recovery. Our bereaved, we want to keep in prayer Sister Vicki Webb Franklin, Brother Roderick Webb, and Dr. Darrell Webb, and the family of the late and a beloved part of our church family, amen, Sister Geraldine Hemphill Webb. Sister Geraldine Webb was a faithful part of our Beulah family, amen. She departed from this world a few days ago. Amen. And we want you to know that a funeral service will convene here on next Saturday, April 6th at the 11 a.m. hour. There will be a viewing next Friday from April 5th from 12 o'clock noon until 8 p.m. Family hours are 5 until 8 p.m. at the Gregory Levitt and Sons Funeral Home, the Flat Shows location. Also, our prayers are requested for Brother James King and family, whose sister Barbara Jones was funeralized in Washington, D.C. on yesterday. Let us pray for Sister Stephanie Riley and family, whose mother, Warnell Riley, was funeralized on yesterday. And lastly, our prayers are going out for Sister Tracy Taylor and family and the passing of her mother. Amen. God sees and God knows, and God shall supply all of our needs. Let's keep these loved ones in our prayers. Choir, can you give me a short selection? Choir, can you give me a short selection as we prepare for the baby dedication? This done, amen, amen. We certainly want to prepare as our deacons take their stations, our ushers take theirs, amen, so that we can quickly march around for this time of tithes and offerings, amen. And the choir will continue to bless us, amen, as we come. Thank you. directions of the ushers. Father God, we thank you now for the faithfulness of your people. Dear Father, we thank you for those, dear Father, who have given their tithes, their offerings, their vision pledges, other forms of financial support to help us continue the good work here at Beulah. We ask now your blessings upon all of them. Supply those things that they stand in need of, and even extra blessings that they didn't even request. For we ask it all in Jesus' name, and we say thank you, and amen, amen, amen. Thank you so very much. Amen, amen. On Fourth Sundays, we do something else very special. We dedicate precious little ones to the God that has blessed their parents and families with them. This Fourth Sunday is no different, for there are some special little ones to be dedicated here. And we're so grateful and thankful for each of these. Amen. The first of these little Miss Araya Monroe Trixie, I hope I got that right, Ari. Parents, Mr. and Mrs. Daryl Trixie, amen. Mother Nikki, amen. Hi. With family members who are here, with little Ari, and parents, please stand. Amen. Really? No wonder you're smiling so much. It's her grandbaby. Father God, we thank you for little Ari. We thank you for her parents, for all family members who have made their way here today. Now, Heavenly Father, we dedicate little Ari to you, asking that you will bless her with long life, health, and strength, and bless her to come to know you early in her life as her Savior and her Lord. For we dedicate her to you now. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Right, little Chloe. Chloe, Chevelle Kempson. And Kobe, Terrell Kempson. Mother, Ashley Hicks. So these two are twins. Amen. With family members who are here, amen. With these two precious twins, please stand. Amen. Father, we thank you for little Chloe. And dear Father, we thank you for her parents and family. And we, dear Father, pray and ask that you will bless little Chloe with long life, health, and strength. Bless her to come to know you early in her life as both Savior and Lord. For we dedicate Chloe to you now in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Father, we thank you for little Kobe. We thank you for his parents and for other family members who are with us today. And Father, we ask now your blessings upon little Kobe. Bless him with long life, health, and strength. And let him come to know you early in his life as Savior and Lord. For we dedicate him to you now in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Parents, just briefly, we thank God for these precious little ones. Children are a gift to us from God. But it is incumbent upon all of us as parents to strive to the best of our ability to raise these children in the knowledge of the Lord. And that can't be done unless you have knowledge of him yourself and live the lives before them that will enable them to see the reality of being children of God. Go forth now, and we pray God's blessings upon each of you. Live the lives that are so very important, that these children may grow up in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Go forth now, and God bless you. Thank you.
away my sins. Nothing
but the blood of Jesus.
Ooh. What can make me whole?
Jesus Christ! Lord shed his blood. Father, I thank you because you know me. And even that you know me and you know all the things that I've done, you still went to the cross. You shed your blood. Your blood has redeemed me. Your blood has saved me. And it's nothing but the blood of my Jesus. Hallelujah.
Power. 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 Wonder-working power.
It's in the blood.
Thank God for the blood of the Lamb. Thank God for the power, the wonder-working power that's in the Savior's blood. Thank you so much, choir. I would that you would come briefly with me to a few verses of scripture that are found today in the third book of the New Testament, the Gospel of St. Luke. Come with me to St. Luke, the 22nd chapter. St. Luke, the 22nd chapter. We will begin reading at verse 41 and continue reading through verse 44. St. Luke, the 22nd chapter, verses 41 through 44. And it reads on this wise. And he was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast, and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. And there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him. And being in an agony, he prayed more earnestly. And his sweat was, as it were, great drops of blood falling to the ground. And I lift up verse 42 for the sake of emphasis. Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. Jesus has been talking to his Father in prayer. He's been talking to his Father about something. Something that is significant, something that is relevant to each one of us. He's been talking to his Father about a cup. He's been talking to his Father about a cup that he wish his Father would remove. A cup that he wished his Father would take away from him. Jesus had great concern about this cup. And I would that you would pray with me, because all of us will have a cup. I would that you would pray with me and think with me on this thought: handling your cup. Handling your cup. And if the household of faith would indulge, I would that you would repeat the thought after me, if you will: handling your cup. God bless you. It was during the period that many theologians call the pre-crucifixion period. Jesus, as we know, had entered into the city of Jerusalem riding on a donkey that some of the writers refer to as a colt. There were resounding shouts of Hosanna. Blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Now, many things happen during the pre-crucifixion period. Time will not permit me to deal with them in this worship service, but I do want to focus on something that occurred during the pre-crucifixion period in a garden called Gethsemane. In that garden called Gethsemane, Jesus, joined by 11 of his disciples, have come. Scripture tells us Jesus had entered the garden for a powerful purpose: to pray. He had come into the Garden of Gethsemane to engage in that thing called prayer, to talk, to communicate, to engage in dialogue with his Father in prayer. Now, at the time of our text, Jesus has left his disciples at one location, and he has gone further into the garden all by himself. He had gone into the garden all by himself to talk to God. I wondered why he would leave his disciples at a certain location and he depart and go further into the garden. But Jesus wanted to talk to his Father in what I refer to as private prayer. Private prayer that would be heard by nobody else but his Father. Now, this is not to launch an assault or an attack against public prayer. There is a place in the Christian movement for public prayer. But brothers and sisters, there's also a place for private prayer. And I submit to you from this holy pulpit that our private prayers must greatly outnumber our public prayer. Somebody knows what I'm talking about. Jesus wanted to pray on this occasion to his Father in private prayer. Which brings me to the first point as we hurry, and that is the importance of private prayer. Number one, the importance of private prayer. Brothers and sisters, oh, we need to talk to God on occasions when we are all by ourselves. Talk to God. Because there are some things that I can talk to God about that are so personal. Some things, brothers and sisters, that are so personal until they're not meant for the ears of other people. Are you going to talk with me? Yeah. There's some things that I need to talk to God about that you don't need to know about. And oh, Jesus talked to God on this occasion in private prayer. Prayer all by himself, talking to God. Prayers that were meant for no one's ears or no other ears but the ears of God. And while we don't know everything that he said, Luke does tell us something, oh brothers, that he said. He said, Father, oh, let this cup pass from me. Jesus was talking to his Father about something called a cup. Now, the cup was symbolic. It was not a literal cup, but it was a symbolic cup. It was symbolic of the pain, the misery, the tremendous agony that he would shortly have to endure. And he was talking to his Father in private prayer. Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Oh, the Lord wanted me to tell you that all of us will have our bitter cups. Mine may differ from yours, and yours may differ from mine, but if you hang around this place called Earth long enough, each one of us will have our bitter cups. Cups that are filled with bitter situations, bitter circumstances. That are difficult for us to deal with. And I don't know whether you're even willing to be a witness, but is there anybody in here who has ever had to deal with something? Who's been faced with a situation or circumstances that were bitter? So bitter until you cried out to the Lord, take it away. Remove it. Take it away, Lord. Jesus, in his prayer, had beseeched God, his Father, to remove, to take away this cup. Oh, it was the cup, oh, brothers and sisters, of agony. It was the cup that was soon to be experienced by him of tremendous pain and suffering. Lord, take it away. The word tells us here that Jesus would soon have to go to a place called Calvary, and he would soon be crucified. Now, you and I, even with the best of our imagination, will never be able to know all that Jesus encountered. We can read what is recorded in the Word, but still it does not capture everything that the Lord endured. And I think I need to tell you, because I don't want anybody to get mixed up and confused. Jesus was not trying to back out or renege on his purpose for coming into the world. No. But by saying, Father, remove this cup, he was saying, in essence, Lord, Father, if there is any other way that this goal of man's redemption and salvation can be accomplished, Lord, remove this cup and let me deal with the alternative. But all brothers and sisters, Jesus realized, as we must realize, there are some cups that we will have to bear, some bitter situations that we will have to endure, some bitter experiences that each of us will have to encounter. And let me tell you, brothers and sisters, everybody will have their cup. No matter how wealthy you are, no matter how renowned you are and prestigious you are, no matter how many degrees you have obtained, no matter how famous you are, Everybody will eventually have their cups. If you don't believe me, ask Princess Catherine. Over in England, you know, member of the royal family. For months, people had wondered why she could not be seen. But then we found out that she had a cup. A cup called cancer. So even those in palaces will have their cups. You know, bitter cups don't discriminate. It doesn't matter what race, creed, or color you are. Everybody eventually will have their cup. Now, I got a question for y'all. What is your cup? You may not know it, but somebody came through those doors. Somebody is seated on a pew, either a pew with you, or a pew in front of you, or pews behind you. Somebody came in here who is dealing with a bitter cup. And sometimes we get mad with God when He doesn't take these cups away. But there are some things you and I will have to endure. Oh, yes. Oh, brothers and sisters, it brings me, to the second point. And that is, brothers and sisters, the need to submit ourselves to the will of God. You see, if God doesn't remove your cup, it's because He wills for us to endure it. Yes, He wills for you and I to go through it. And Jesus, brothers and sisters, in this prayer, didn't just ask God to remove the cup, but He said, nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. Didn't He say it? Oh, look at here. Jesus shows us how to handle our cups. Submit yourself to whatever proves to be God's will. Yeah. And Jesus submitted Himself, saying, nevertheless, you know, we need a faith when we're facing these cups that will say, nevertheless. I should have entitled this sermon, nevertheless. Jesus says, nevertheless, if it's not your will to take it away, I'm going to bear it. And I'm asking, dear Father, that your will be done. Now, it's going to hurt me. I'm going to go through some pain and agony. I'm going to deal with some excruciating suffering. But nevertheless, thy will be done. At all, he prayed to the Father. But let me move now to what got me happy at the house. Can I share that? I believe if it caused me to shout, it can have the same effect on you. Somebody hadn't shouted in a long time. Somebody's been so overwhelmed and preoccupied with your cup until it has robbed you of your ability to praise God and shout. Somebody is long overdue for a good shout. Maybe if you shouted too, you wouldn't look at me and some other folk. So cross-eyed. Oh, let me tell you what blessed me. After the Lord had finished this portion of his prayer, saying, "Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done." Let me tell you what happened. God sent an angel to Jesus' location. And that angel, scripture says, strengthened Jesus. Gave Jesus strength. Yes. To deal with his suffering. To deal with that bitter cup. Oh, yes. Yes. When you look at, Luke, when you look at verse 43 of Luke 22, you'll see these words, "And there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him." Yes, God sent him some angelic help. At all, brothers and sisters, I think I need to tell you, if you just hold on, if you just tell God, whether you take away this bitter cup or whether you choose by virtue of your will to leave it with me, dear Father, thy will be done. Now the record tells us an angel came from heaven and ministered to Jesus. Ministered to the minister. Listen here. You need to know that the minister needs to be ministered to. Oh, yes. Oh, brothers and sisters, this angel ministered to Jesus, and for years I had read it and failed to see the importance of this verse. But let me tell you something. The Lord wanted me to come here and tell somebody who's dealing with a bitter cup some angels are coming. Lean over and tell somebody, if you just hold on, angels are coming. And the angels are going to minister to you. The angels are going to help you bear your bitter cup. Tell somebody on the other side of you, some angels are coming. Well, I think I ought to tell you. Oh, that Jesus handled his cup. I know he did. He handled his cup. The reason I know he handled it is because he went on to Calvary. And he dealt with all of the bitter situations that he had to endure. And you know what helps me? Sometimes I think my suffering is the worst that there could ever be. But let me tell you something. A man named Jesus suffered far more than me and you. I know. He handled his cup. Because he went on to Calvary. And let them put nails in his hands. Nails in his feet. And nail him to that rugged thing of torture called a cross. But oh, I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, he handled it. I know he handled it because he handled it so well until even while some people were mocking him and scorning him, Jesus still had love for those who were working against him. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them. Let me tell you, to handle your cup, you got to learn how to forgive. I know everybody don't like it. I know I'm all up in somebody's business. But I got to tell you, if you're going to handle your cup, you got to learn how to let some stuff go. You're holding on to mess, and it's messing up your heart. It's messing up your mind. It's messing up your spirit. Tell somebody, you got to let it go. You got to let it go. Tell them, you got to turn it loose. I still see some of you that ain't saying it. I still see some of you that's looking cross-eyed because you think you're justified in hating people who have mistreated you, in hating people who have done you wrong. But oh, you've got to turn it loose. Oh, turn it loose. Oh, brothers and sisters, Jesus handled his cup. Didn't he do it? Well, as I leave you, I've got a cup. You have a cup. So many of us have our cups. But I've learned if I just tell the Lord, Lord, I'm turning it over to you and not my will, but thy will be done. And oh, brothers and sisters, the Lord heard the master's cry. Didn't he do it? God will give you power to handle your cup. Oh, let me come down here. Oh, shucks. Let me come down here. You never would have made it. You never would have survived if God had not been there to help you handle your cup. Can I get a witness? You could have gone crazy. You could have lost your mind. But the Lord gave you strength. The Lord gave you power. The Lord helped you to handle your cup. And oh, if there's anybody here who can witness that I would have been swept away, I never would have been able to stand the things that the devil was doing. If God had not given me the power to handle my cup, and oh, if he's given you power, wonder working power, to handle your cup, I wonder, is there a few brave people who don't mind being a witness, who will walk down here and shake my hand? Are there some people who don't mind shaking my hand and letting everybody know that I never would have made it? I never would have survived, but I'm still here because God gave me the strength to handle my cup. God gave me the power to handle my cup. God came to my rescue. God heard my cry. God pitied my groan. God brought me out of storms, trials, tribulations. God, God brought me out of hardships and distress. God took care of me when I couldn't care for myself. God walk with me so I wouldn't be alone. God! Hey! Oh, yes! I'm still here. Tell somebody, I don't care how rough it gets, I'm gonna put it in the hands of the Father, and He's gonna help me to handle my a song when I was growing up in the church that said, I started with Jesus and I'm going through. I'm going through. No matter what the world may do, I'll take the way with the Lord's despised few. I started with Jesus and I'm going through. I'm going through. The doors of the church are open. Somebody needs to come to the man who can help you handle your cup. Every devil, every demon in hell is gonna try to tell you don't come, don't walk out. But don't let nothing and nobody stop you. Come, come to the one who can help you to handle your cup. God bless you, my sister. Yes, yes, yes. Come on, come on, come on. God bless you, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, my brother. God bless you. Somebody else needs to walk out. I can go on.
I can go on.
God bless you, my friend. If you're in the balcony, come down the side aisles or take the elevator. There he is. The cups get too bitter. God bless you, my sister. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Oh, yes. God bless you. Lord, touch hearts right now. When you walk out. God is going to help us. Tell somebody he's going to send some angels. To help us with our bitter cups. In fact, there's a few angels in here right now. Get ready to bring this service to a close. Father God, we thank you. But while we know that bitter cups will come, thank you, Lord, for the fact that you will help us just like you helped Jesus. You will help us with our bitter cups. Father, we lift up your people to you right now. And we pray your blessings upon them. Father, we pray right now that they will join with me in claiming victory. In receiving this word, in the name of Jesus. Now we ask that the grace of you, our God, the love of our Savior Jesus Christ, the sweet communion of your powerful, wonderful Holy Spirit will rest, rule, and abide with each of us now, henceforth, and yes, Lord, even forevermore. For we ask it all in Jesus' name. And we say thank you, Lord. And amen. 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 Amen.